Hi gang, Bill Greenberg with PhoneScholar.com, and yes, we've made it through another week. Today is Friday, August 6, 2010, and here's a look at what we got on the website today. First look, I got a video on there for you from Adriana at PhoneDog.com, and it's first look Samsung Epic 4G from Sprint. Now, for those of you who don't know, the Epic is the Galaxy S version for Sprint, to go along with the AT&T Captivate, the T-Mobile Fascinate, excuse me, Fiber, and I keep getting that wrong, the Verizon Fascinate, and the US Cellular Galaxy S. Sorry, there's five carriers carrying it, and then of course the Epic for Sprint. It's the only one that does have the full slider keyboard along with the touch screen, so if you want a hard keyboard with that, that's something to check out. But check out the video. It looks like a really, really terrific phone, and it looks like it's going to give the EVO 4G a run for its money. Speaking of which, hit HTC EVO 4G Android 2.2 upgrade. And again, this is a video. This is from Aaron at PhoneDog.com, who goes through all the steps of the new upgrade for the Froyo 2.2. And it looks like it has some really, really great upgrades. It simplified some things. It added some things. And for those of you who had the who have the EVO and been dealing with the 2.1, I think you'll be very, very pleased with going to 2.2. Both articles, I also put the links to the actual websites so you can go to them and see what the comments made on the videos also, and then the feedback that those two people give. So something to take a look at. Next, Droid X will get Froyo by early September, Motorola says. And basically, the Droid, Motorola Droid, has been rolling out the Froyo 2.2 all this week. Wednesday, supposedly, the largest rollout went out. If you do have a Droid and you haven't gotten the 2.2 network grade yet, don't panic. It is coming. They have assured everybody that it is coming, but that should be done, and then the Droid X will be back early September. There hasn't been any word on the Incredible yet, even though all the reports said late July, early August, which is what we're in now, so hopefully that'll come through soon. Now, the other thing is, if you do have an Android and you're wondering if it's going to get an upgrade or when, the update list for the 2.2 I put at the end of the article, there's a link for that, and it's a great, great update, and what I would do is bookmark that, and then every time you go and refresh it, it'll show you, because it was just updated yesterday, August 5th. So take a look at that. Next, iPad knockoffs on sale for $50 to $125, and there's things called ePad and iPad being sold through the eBay. Now, the retailers on there are 100% legitimate. They're 98.9 to 99.3 rated, so they're very, very good. These things are coming from China mostly. Most of them don't have any warranties. They only have up to 2 weeks return policies, if anything. And most of them have zero technical support or very little if they do have it. They're also using the storage capacity is only 2 gigs, which is actually less than the iPad Nano from 5 years ago. It has a it's using an Android processor, but it's a 1.7 processor and only a 7-inch screen compared to the 9.7-inch screen. They do say it also may be using retired parts and that the plastic casing may be a little bit inferior. So again, you're getting what you pay for. I know a lot of you can only afford something like this, so please just be aware when you do purchase something like this. You are getting what you pay for. So now, under categories, Apple and iPhone categories. Apple addresses iOS security flaw, and they're creating the fix for it for that PDF flaw that the malicious malware people were going in behind and loading on applications to get in behind there, so people were getting malware on their phone and malicious things were going on. Now the question I had is the jailbreak application was kind of using that same path to get behind the iPhone applications and do the jailbreak. So I'm wondering if they fix that, if that's going to take that away too. I don't know. If any of you have a better knowledge on that, please let me know at blogquestions@phonescholar.com, and I'd be happy to post it for you. Under Android category, 200,000 Android devices sold daily. Think about that. 200,000, that equates to 73 million a year. That's tremendous. And this is worldwide, of course. But what's going to happen is Android basically is going to take over the market if they keep going the way they're going, and nothing else changes. Now, of course, with the amount of phones that they're offering and the amount of carriers that they're going through, that kind of makes sense. The only thing that's going to shoot them in the foot is supply issues, which they've already run into with a number of phones. So if they can resolve all their supply issues, then the sky's the limit for them. So I'm pretty impressed with that. Lastly, under the data and the network categories, mobile malware. You will be billed $90,000 for this call. And a gentleman named Mikko Hipponen, I apologize if I'm not pronouncing that right, from S-Secure Corp, and there's a video on there, a link to a video on there. The video wouldn't load directly, but there's a link to a video on there kind of in the middle of this section, and he talks about how people are starting to be going out to the phones for hacking, putting malware on, and making money on that. And basically, he does describe how there was one 3D target game that had malware put in behind that. It sat dormant for 31 days, and then when it kicked in, it made the phone from the behind the phone scenes make 8 phone calls, very expensive international phone calls to places like North Africa and North Korea and Antarctica. And even the phone's call might actually be routed to Canada or something like that. The actual phone billing was going to that further country. And somehow the person who wrote the virus got the extra money for the difference of that. Not quite sure how that works. He explains it better in the video. But they also do offer, F-Secure Corp offers a protection for your phone, for your smartphone. For 24 months, it's $59.99. And for 12 months, it's $39.99. Again, I did put a direct link to that hookup if you want to go ahead and check that out. They also offer a 7-day free trial, so that's pretty cool. That's all I got for today and for this week. I hope you had a great week. I hope you have a great weekend. And I will talk to you Monday, of course, for everything. And to see the complete stories and all the videos, check out www.phonescholar.com. Talk to you later.